Hey guys, it's Zung, and if you guys are new to the channel, I am a cookbook author who just came out with the Honeysuckle Cookbook here, and today we're actually gonna be making one of my favorite breakfast recipes, the matcha almond loaf. The matcha almond breakfast loaf, to be more specific. If you guys wanna check out my book, be sure to check the link in the description box below. And if you end up buying it on Amazon or have bought it, be sure to leave me your best review or just give me 5 stars. That'd be really helpful. Otherwise, just crush that like button and we'll go ahead and get started with making the bread. Fun fact, when I was working at a corporate job, I used to be called the quick bread queen. I love making quick bread, so I used to make them and give it to all of my friends. I'm gonna start with the dry ingredients first. It's really easy. Just mix flour. You have 1.5 cups here. Add it to a bowl. And then I'll mix in my baking powder, which was right here. Oh, here it is. 1 teaspoon. 1/2 teaspoon of kosher salt. So I like using kosher salt just because it's a little less salty to me than regular table salt. If you guys have table salt, I would take it down to 1/4 teaspoon. So see, the granules are a lot bigger. And I use this for cooking, baking, everything really. Just sprinkle it in. And then 1 tablespoon of matcha powder. Now for baking, you don't have to use super expensive matcha powder. I have a jar like this that I got, I think from Costco, and it was 20 bucks for this giant thing, and you just keep it in a cool dark place, unless you're filming like I am, so it's out. Like, just buy cooking grade matcha, the ceremonial type, the really expensive one, are best enjoyed drinking. So just add that in. And as we always like to say, mix, mix, mix. All right, so that's pretty much it for the dry ingredients. Now this is like the easiest recipe ever, but it comes out so yummy. I remember when we were shooting this specific photo for the cookbook, they made it like the first day of the shoot, and I ate it all the way up until Friday. We started on a Monday, ended on a Friday, and it was still nice and moist and flavorful. It didn't really dry out. The key is to underbake it a little bit, which I instructed you to do so in here. For the wet ingredients, we're gonna start with some melted butter. I melted a whole stick of butter and just let it cool down a little bit. Then I need 3/4 cup of granulated sugar, which I will grab right now. 2 eggs, but I'm gonna add 1 in at a time, and then just whisk it up after each addition. So 1. These eggs are from our chickens outside, and it's been a game changer to have chickens. Just mix it in really well. Then 2nd one. The yolks are nice and yellow. It's gotten more orange as we've continued to just like give them better food. I give them all of my scraps. Lots of worms, protein, but I'm working on getting them really orange. Like, my sister has chickens and they come out like fiery orange, not like fiery orange, but they're like a brighter orange color, not like this one. So if you guys have any tips or have raised chickens, let me know. And also, this is a new series that I'm starting up. It's more of a relaxed, casual, trying new recipes. I know I get a lot of requests to try to cook different things, like sinigang. Someone asked me that. I've never made it before. So stuff that you guys request that I've never made before will go into this type of series, or I may just stick with like breakfast. So you guys let me know what you guys want, and if you guys have a fun title for it, let me know in the comment section below. For example, Bon Appetit has gourmet makes, or they have like home in the kitchen. I think I wanna come up with the swanky name for my channel too, or like the series too. So yeah, I need your help though. Okay, so we have our eggs in. Now we're gonna add vanilla extract, 1 teaspoon. And then because it's a matcha almond loaf, we're gonna add sliced almond, but to give it more of that almond kick, which is really, really delicious with matcha, I'm gonna add 1/2 teaspoon of almond extract. You can get almond extract at pretty much any grocery store. Whisk that in. So now this method, I'm gonna do a little bit differently. So usually people would just add the milk in and then the flour at the final, but I kind of took the approach of how I would make cupcakes or like cake to keep it really moist and not overwork the gluten. So I will do 1/2 of our dry mixture here, add it in, mix it with our milk, half of our milk. So I have 3/4 of a cup here. I'm just gonna eyeball it. I'm gonna mix it until it's almost incorporated. So the reason why I'm doing this is because I don't wanna overmix the batter because that causes a really dry quick bread. And nobody likes a dry breakfast loaf. So we're gonna do it in sequence. And as you can see, the batter is still pretty lumpy, but that's totally fine. Now I'm gonna add the rest of our batter in, and the rest of our milk, and finish mixing it all together. I'm just going in a circle like this, and then mixing it into the middle. So circle, middle. It's pretty lumpy, but once you bake it off, it'll work beautifully. Okay, so we're gonna add this to the loaf pan. This is my cute little loaf pan. It's ceramic or porcelain, but you can definitely use a metal one. Let me just quickly oil this, and then just use your fingers to spread the oil or butter, whatever you have on hand. You don't want your bread to be sticking. And then get a little bit of flour, like a tablespoon, and just move it all around so that it coats that oil. Tap out the excess, and then we're gonna pour our batter in. So I'm using a loaf pan for this, but if you wanted to, you can definitely use a muffin tin and just make them smaller. This looks good. I'm gonna set it aside real quick, and we're just gonna put together the streusel topping. So for the streusel, I'm starting with 1 tablespoon of melted butter. This one's obviously a little hot, so I'm gonna let it cool for a couple minutes while I get the rest of the stuff ready. Sliced almonds for a matcha almond loaf. Honestly, the streusel really takes this up to another level of deliciousness. Just that extra crunch into that beautiful, grassy, but sweet matcha flavor. This recipe is definitely a winner. So if you guys love matcha and if you love breakfast, you have to try it. And so far it's pretty easy to do, right? So I feel like the butter is pretty good. 2 tablespoons of flour. Just sprinkle it in. 1 tablespoon of granulated sugar. 1 tablespoon of brown sugar. A dash of cinnamon. I like a lot of cinnamon, so we'll add more than a dash. And then 1/4 teaspoon of kosher salt. And finally, 1/4 cup of sliced almonds. With this, you can use your hands or just use a fork to really break it up. I'm gonna grab a baby spatula and just mix it all together, making sure that the butter really coats, that it almost becomes like a very dry paste, but a paste nonetheless. And if you guys are thinking, that's kind of a lot of sugar, honestly, it's not. I made sure that this wasn't super sugary so that it balances out with the streusel topping when we spread it on top, which is what I'm gonna do now. I like to make sure that the corners are also filled because that's where it's gonna get really crystallized and caramely and delicious. Okay, this looks really beautiful. Just spread it out if you need to. All right, and then into the oven it goes at 350 degrees, and it does take a little bit to bake, 40 to 45 minutes. I would actually check it at 35 minutes to make sure that it's not getting cooked too quickly or done, basically. And I'll show you guys with a toothpick how I do that. So while we wait for the matcha almond loaf to bake, I have a really quick and exciting announcement. So I will actually be on the Today Show. It's like a dream come true to talk to Hoda, and I think I'm gonna be talking to Savannah Guthrie. I am gonna be making one of my parents' recipes, actually, which is really, 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 really special. And I really wish my dad were still here to see this, because he'd be so proud. But we are gonna be making this grilled salmon with tamarind sauce. It's my favorite recipe, honestly. It's such an easy and flavorful and new spin on how you would normally eat salmon. My parents used to do this with catfish, but I don't really like catfish. And we're gonna pair it with this crispy Brussels sprouts with chili lime garlic sauce. If you guys love Brussels sprouts and you're tired of having it with bacon, definitely this recipe is a sure winner. But make sure to tune in on NBC, the Today Show, on October 19th, Monday at 8:50 Eastern Time, 5:50 Pacific time. I will be up bright and early. I believe they will be replaying it on West Coast time at the same time. So if you don't wake up early enough, you can definitely catch it at 8:50. Yeah, so 8:50 wherever you are. Okay. Does that look beautiful or what? The top is kind of cracked and it's risen up quite a bit. Now I'm just gonna stick a toothpick in right here where it's pretty high to see if it comes out. Hey, this looks pretty good. Let me try another area. Yeah, like you can still see a little bit of crumb stuck to it, but this is exactly how I want it to look. This is good. I actually pulled it out at 38 minutes just because that oven runs a little bit hot. Now I'm just gonna let it cool down for about 30 minutes and then we're gonna crack it open and I'll show you the matcha goodness inside. They know what's up, especially when we're filming. Cece, I don't know if you can eat this one. Can you say matcha?
Matcha.
This is matcha powder.
That's just matcha powder.
That's right.
I can be quiet.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so here is the almond loaf. Ta-da! Here's the center. It's just beautiful. The center, look at it. So soft and fluffy. But the best part, in my opinion, is the edge where you have that nice brown crusty sugar. I'm gonna regret this.
I want mommy.
Do you like it?
Yeah. I can get my mommy.
This matcha almond loaf would be so delicious with a hot cup of coffee in the morning, or you can double the matcha and have it with the matcha latte. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Again, if you guys are interested in checking out my cookbook, I'll leave the link in the description box below. Thanks so much for watching. Give this video a like and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.
Bye. Bye bye photos.
Bye bye YouTube.
Yeah. Bye YouTube. Bye YouTube.
See you next time.
See you next time. Bye YouTube.